Hi everyone, welcome to Python Learning Series for Network Engineers. In this video, we'll see some details about Nornia configuration file and inventory. In the previous video about Nornia, we have seen a basic script, how to write a basic script using Nornia library, and we've seen some basics about configuration file and inventory, and how to write script without using configuration file. If you don't use configuration file, you need to have a default file host.yaml. And if you want to understand about that more, please have a look into the previous video. I'll add the video URL in the notification. As I have mentioned in the previous video, Nornia is an automation framework written in Python. It provides 100% Python framework, so even if you want to do some advanced troubleshooting, you only need to know Python. That is one advantage with Nornia, and it can leverage other external libraries such as Netmiko, Paramiko, Napalm, etc., and it supports concurrency. This is the script which we have written in the previous video. So you can see here I was using a configuration file 01config.yaml, and then it was using Napalm underscore get method for getting all the facts and interface, environment, interface, IP outputs from each device which I have added in my host.yaml file. Now we'll try to execute the script first. Yeah, this is the output which we got after executing the script. We can see here it contacted individual device and fetched all the defined outputs, facts, interfaces, environment, interface, IP. So in my inventory file, you can see I have three devices: RTR1 is a Cisco router, switch 1 is an Arista switch, RTR2 is Cisco router again. Now what we would do, we will uncomment this section and try to run the script again. And if you run this script, we'll get file not found error, because in my script I'm referring to a configuration file 01config.yaml. So I'll copy all these files which I used in the previous video. I'll paste it here. Now we don't need this host.yaml file. Now we'll try to run the script again. We would get same output, but you can see here in my configuration file I am referring to the host file, then group file and defaults file. In host file you can see the device is under a group, Cisco group, and Arista device is under Arista group. And under groups I have defined platforms for each vendors. Then in defaults file I have mentioned username and password. Earlier we used single host.yaml file for everything. Now we'll try to execute the script again. Yeah, we got same output. I have mentioned earlier that if you don't use any configuration file, it will go and fetch the default values, and only file we need is host.yaml. Now we'll see those details. So this is the official document for Nornia. We'll go to configuration. So here you can see, you can set configuration file programmatically using dictionaries or YAML file. In my case, I have used a YAML file. So you can see here the content of configuration file. So core, you can see number of workers, it is given 20. Then for inventory, it is using simple inventory. There are multiple types of inventories available in Ornia. It can even support Ansible inventory file. Then there are some options like host file, group file, and if we compare it with my configuration, I have given defaults file as well, and number of workers I have given 100. So we'll see the details about that. So this is how you can set it programmatically. You can just write a dictionary inside init nonia. So that means inside this, instead of defining file, you can just give these values. By default, nonia automatically configures logging. Then core means, under core you can see number of workers, that means number of threads that can run at same time. The default value is 20. We'll see some details about that. Then under inventory, the inventory plugins, what it supports. So here it shows simple inventory. So similar way you can use other supported inventory formats. Yeah, now we will see where these supporting files are located in Nonia folder. Here you can go to this folder. So this is my Nonia installation folder in Python, and core deserializer configuration.py. If you see this file, you can see some default values. So you can see here the number of workers is 20 by default. And another file which you want to have a look is, so in core folder you can see multiple files, configuration, then connections, inventory, state, task, connections and all we'll see in the upcoming videos. Now we'll see configuration and inventory. So if you're interested, you can refer all these files, how it takes values. Now we'll have a look into inventory file. For that we'll go to the official site here. Under plugins, we can see inventory. So you can see there are three categories: simple inventory, Ansible, and NSOT. NSOT stands for Network Source of Truth. It is an application that gives REST API and a web application front end for managing IP address or networking devices. In our case, we use simple inventory, and even we can use Ansible inventory file for getting the device list in Nonia. So if we go to simple inventory, so you can see some format or syntax for using simple inventory. Similar way for Ansible also they have given. And for NSOT, you can see here the variables required are NSOT URL, email, authentication header, secret key. We'll see some details about that. For that, what we can do, we'll go to Nonia core, then inventory.py. So here you can see the values which are mandatory and optional. and you have seen in the host file what are the values are used. So you'll be able to correlate all these with this file. And another file which you need to refer is under Nornia plugins, then inventory. So here you can see all the files: ansible.py, nsot.py, simple.py. So in our case we use simple inventory, so we can refer here. By default it uses host.yaml, group.yaml and defaults.yaml file names. If you don't use any configuration file, we need to set values using this. Similar way for Ansible inventory, you can see some details here. For NSOT also, you can see the values which it requires: NSOT URL, email address, secret key, authentication header, etc. Now we'll see how to do filtering in inventory. For that we need to go to tutorials, inventory. So here you can see one document, it is very easy to understand. So here they have created a file host.yaml and all the hosts they have added under this, and you can see some data they have added like site, role, type, etc. And all these devices under some groups. So you can see this is the host one is under CMH, host 2 also. Yeah, this host 1.bma is under group BMA. Similar way, there is a host file and group file. In group file, define all the groups. Then an inventory file where defined only domain name acme.local. Then for accessing inventory file, we need to execute this line. So I'll copy this and we'll try to execute it in our script. If we do a napalm run, napalm get calls, there is going to be a delay. So anyway, we are just going to see only filtering in the list or inventory, so we'll execute only that. So I have commented the print statement and I have given only print nr.inventory.host. Try to execute the script now. Yeah, you can see here a dictionary with all the hosts which are available in my in host file. So RTR1, switch 1 and RTR2. Similar way, if you want to print the groups, you can just execute groups here. Yeah, now this prints only the group names. We'll go to the document. Now if you want to get values of particular host, what you can do is we'll go to the script. We'll give the host name of our device, it is RTR1. Then I'll give a print save. Let's try to execute the script. Yeah, Now we'll add some values to the host. So we'll take it from this file, we'll add site. We'll add in the host file. Now we'll try to execute the script. Yeah. Now you can see the dictionary key value, it is site. Now if you want to do some filter, what we can do? I'll go to the script and I'll give a statement, print host site. Let's try to execute it again. Yeah, now it is printing the site name. So you can do a lot of customization even in your inventory using all these methods. This document is very helpful. You can just go through this and it is very easy to understand. I hope this video was helpful for you to understand configuration, file and inventory basics. In the upcoming videos, we will see connections, task, plugin details of Nonia library. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.